Welcome back to the next video of Google Apps Script Course. In this video, we're going to explore about the macro option available in Google Sheet. So basically, if you are already have an experience on an Excel VBA program, then you have no definition of what is a macro and what is the use of macro. And the same feature was added to Google Sheets a few months ago. It was mostly inspired from an Excel VBA macro. So the purpose of the macro is to convert a certain action into a script format so that you can execute the script to do the same action over and over again on your paper sheet. So that is called as a macro. And in Google Sheet, there are two types of macro. So if you want to see more details about macro, go to tools and macros. And there is a two option, record macro and manage macro. And the options shown here are the macros which was added to this Google Sheet. So first, when you click on record macro, you can see a two option: use absolute reference and use relative reference. So when you go with an absolute reference, whatever the action that you're doing, it will take or it will output the location as well. So if you're doing certain action on B3, and whenever you're executing the macro, it will do the action on B3 only, because when you go with an absolute, the location or the range or the cell value will be hard coded in app script. But when you go with the relative, it will take what are the cursor, what are the active. So for example, if you place the cursor in B13, it will take this as a reference and execute your macro. So let us see the difference between absolute and relative macro. So first I will go with absolute reference, and I'm clicking on a cell G2. And I'm adding a formula to add two numbers. So let me save that one. So when you're saving, you have to give a macro name. Let's say addition absolute. And if you want to create a shortcut, if you want to give a shortcut, you can give any number here, but make sure that the number should always be unique when you are having multiple macros on your Google Sheet. And you can call particular action using by pressing Ctrl Alt Shift and particular number, but this is completely optional, so I will ignore that as of now. So my script got saved. You can click on edit script, or you can go to tools and script editor to see the script. So the action which I have performed, it has created a function and it activated the spreadsheet. And if you see that in absolute reference, the cell value is hard coded, it activates the G2. And it set the formula, whatever the formula which I have entered, it set the formula and execute script. So let's execute. So if you want to execute macro, go to tools, macros, and you can see my macro listed on this macro option. So let me delete this one, because it will go and do the same option, same action on the particular cell. So go to macro, click on addition. So you can see that it execute the action on G2, even if you place the cursor. And let me delete this one. Even if you place a cursor somewhere here, go to macros and click on addition apps. So it executes on the same place, because this location is hard coded in macro function. So if I create a macro with a relative reference, so let me create a new macro, and I change the option to relative reference. And let's say I'm doing the same formula to I2. So let me save the script, and I'm giving the macro name as addition relative. So the macro got saved. If I reload the script, I can see the new macro as well. So it got created here. So if you see the function, if you see the set of code it has generated for the relative reference, you can see that it doesn't hardcode the value G2 anywhere here. So all it takes is it just take an offset and set the value or set a formula to the particular cell. So this is a basic difference between an absolute and relative macro. So if I execute a relative macro here, let's say I'm placing a cursor here and I'm going to tools, macros, and I'm executing the relative reference. It takes this as a reference and execute it here. I say what's up. Before I was doing here, I placed the cursor here. So that was recorded, and I take that as a reference and add the formula here. So in the same way, the related references work. So the related reference is nothing but it take the current active cell as a reference and execute your function, but absolute just output the range and the values, and it will execute that on a particular range or a cell. So there's a basic difference between absolute and relative. And this macro is not really mean for create a script to play back the same action again and again, but this macro, you can use the macro effectively to find out the methods or the values that you need to give in the script to enhance your script. So that is how you should use a macro as a professional Google Apps Script programmer. You should always use a macro to make use of the methods and the scripts it has generated and leverage your script with this function. So it's just not meant for executing the repeated action or to automate a script, to create a script for doing a repeated action. That's not the real purpose of macro. So just for an example, let's say I have a table here and I want to change the color of this data set, but I really don't know what is the code to change the color. So if you don't know the code, then you don't need to go to Google Apps Script tutorial and find out how to change the color or how to add a border to that, how to change the font size using Google Apps Script. You don't need to go and search and find out what the code written here. You can just do the action here and generate a script and go to the script and take that as a reference and create your or put it in your own function. So let me show you. I want to change the color. So first go to tools, script editor, and record macro. I will go with absolute reference because I just want to find the method. I can customize according to my range or according to which sheet, wherever I want to use, I can customize. But all I want is I just want to find the method to change the color. So I'll select this one, and this is an option to change the color. I'm changing it to green color. Also, I just want to increase the font size. So I'll increase it to a bit larger. And what are the other options that I can use? So let's say I just want to transpose this one. So I really don't know the code to do this action, but I did that here and I'm saving the script as my code or something, and go here and refresh. So now you can see that. So to change the color, set font color, and here is the tips. So I just want to change it to a green color. I don't need to go and search what is the value for the green color, because I can run or create a macro and I can find out the color and put it on my code. And you can see that this is a method to set the font size, and I should pass the font size value here. So, and you can see that the action, I have used a rotate option to rotate the cell value, and this is a method to rotate. So this value is given as a degree of rotation. From just saying script, I can understand that. So this is how you should effectively use macro in your Google Apps Script. And that's all about recording option and recording a playback in macro. If you like this video, give thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Thank you. Bye bye.